the meat cleaver and the propane forge at about 20 psi. From a cold start, it takes about 8 minutes to get red hot, working temperature. That will give me on the blade portion about 30 seconds of working time, and about a minute and 30 seconds on the handle before it cools down too much. If you work the metal when it's too cold, you could create stress fractures, and it might not show up until you heat treat it, and then you get a cracked blade, and it's garbage. So you gotta be careful. To reheat the metal, I gotta put it back on the forge after I've worked on it for a couple minutes. At about 10 psi, it takes about 3 minutes to get it back up to working temperature. So here is the forge I'm using. I built this myself from scratch. I have 2 inches thick of kale wool on the inside, and on the bottom, 1 inch of kale wool and 1 inch of fire bricks. I have 3 sliding doors, so depending on the size of the object, I can raise or close the doors, and I can still keep all the heat inside. Up here I have a pressure gauge. Right now I'm running it at 10 psi. It goes all the way up to about 30 psi before the tank has no more pressure in it. So here's the cleaver after forging. I already cut the profile at the front and the cutting edge. Next, I have to cut out the profile I want down here and above. Here I've ground the profile of the cleaver. I've also gotten most of the scale off. But if I go in close, you can still see it's pretty rough. But now that I got my basic shape in, I can start fine-tuning everything and making it nice and smooth. Now I am sanding and polishing the egg part of the cleaver. Very tedious. This is the king behelit done on the pommel. Nose, eye, mouth, and another eye randomly distributed. I'm heating up the cleaver. I'm gonna do an edge quench to harden it. So I got it in the oven right now. I got the 2 burners kind of hovering over the edge. Alright, so I got the oil at about 131 degrees Fahrenheit. I dumped some hot pieces of metal in there to get it to that temperature. And now I'm gonna pull out the cleaver from the forge and test it with the magnet. If it doesn't stick, give it a dunk. Hopefully it doesn't crack. Here we go. Alright, now I'm going to take it out of the oil and let it cool at room temperature until it's safe to handle. Right now I'm going to do a hardness test with a file. So if I go along the edge that we hardened, it kind of just skates across. It doesn't really bite in very well. If I do it on the other edge where we didn't harden, it wants to bite in and really, really file it. I put the cleaver in the oven in my kitchen at 400 degrees Fahrenheit for 2 hours, and this will temper the blade and hopefully get rid of the brittleness. I'm starting to sand the cleaver. I'm starting with 180 grit, and this is wet and dry, so I'm gonna soak with water because it'll sand better. This is 220 grit. 320 grit. 400 grit. 600 grit.
1000 grit. 1500 grit. 2000 grit. 3000 grit. Polishing. This is the finished face on the side of the blade. Here I'm sharpening a knife with starting with 1000 grits. Never done this before, don't really know what I'm doing. This is the finished cleaver. Below it is the piece of steel I started with. The pommel and the face on the side of the blade are based off of the anime Berserk. Also, you'll notice I left in a lot of the marks from forging, just to kind of give it a more rustic and forged look to it. Now let's go test it.